Earlier today, at 3:53 a.m. local time in Iceland, a body of rising magma burst through the ground, beginning a new volcanic eruption of the so-called Reykjanes volcano. As a fissure of lava expanded both to the northeast and southwest, fountains of lava up to 450 feet or 137 meters high arose into the air. Multiple loosely disconnected fissures then followed until soon, a 2,400-meter-long stretch of ground 33 kilometers southwest of Iceland's capital Reykjavik were all erupting molten rock. Thankfully, this eruption occurred with a decent amount of warning and was not completely unexpected. Not only had conditions been deemed suitable for an eruption to begin at any moment for weeks now, but there was also a strong earthquake swarm which began at 12:38 a.m. local time. This quake swarm marked when molten rock drained away from its magma chamber 1,300 meters south-southwest of the Blue Lagoon towards the northeast before spreading out in a lengthy northeast-to-southwest dike. It appeared that some of this magma may have even attempted to intrude underneath the town of Grindavik, but was unable to get shallower than 4 kilometers depth, and thus magma rushed back northeastwards to a weak point where it could and did easily reach the surface. Later in the afternoon, another 500-meter-long fissure emerged, and since this caused magma to rise in an area where unusually abundant groundwater was present, it caused the water to flash the steam. This caused fragmentation of the rising molten rock to occur, generating low-level minor ash emissions. In an eruption that has been ongoing for more than 16 hours now, so far 3.68 square kilometers have been covered in a layer of fresh lava, with lava flows currently advancing in these three directions. Thankfully, all advancing lava flows are seemingly destined to only spread out in areas with no structures or paved roads, meaning their motion so far is not a cause for concern. Several of these aforementioned eruptive fissures were further northeast than any of the Reykjanes volcano's other recent eruptive fissures, giving a decent clue on why lava erupted so easily there. Since late October of 2023, this poorly defined volcanic complex known as Reykjanes, which largely consists of fissure vents, has produced cyclical episodes of magma building in the same magma chamber, running to the northeast and then expanding in the dike to create an eruption. While multiple failed magmatic intrusions have occurred in the 21 months since, what we are witnessing is the volcano's ninth eruption in the same time span. We can use prior eruptions to predict what will happen next at this eruption. In other words, we can eventually expect at first one and then multiple fissures to become inactive as eruptive activity concentrates into a series of smaller dominant fissure segments. These will then form spatter cones, but eventually only one of these will remain active, having the potential to grow to heights of more than 20 meters before ceasing its activity, thus ending the eruption. It is quite difficult to say how long the ongoing eruption will last for, but a good indication in prior eruptions has involved the peak lava infusion involved. This figure, which peaked at around 725 cubic meters per second, suggests an eruption that will last longer than 30 hours, but less than 2 weeks in length. Regardless, the rate of lava effusion has already declined by at least 40% since its peak values earlier in the day. The eruptive rate will continue to decrease in the upcoming days. The advancing lava flows have ignited moss fires, and combined with the sulfur dioxide gas plume, this has reduced visibility in the area of the eruption. Stay tuned for more updates. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Noel Patrick Soberano, for supporting my work.